Since the past couple of weeks, Toronto Raptors rookie guard Jalen Harris has been in the news for all the wrong reasons. It's been reported that Jalen violated the drug program of the NBA. Join me as I take you through Jalen Harris dismissed, disqualified from NBA for drug violation. Number 9. Disqualified from the NBA for one full year. Earlier this month, the NBA announced that it had dismissed and disqualified Toronto Raptors rookie Jalen Harris for violating terms of the league's anti-drug program. Under the NBA's anti-drug program, there are currently more than 250 banned substances by the league, and testing positive for any of them results in an automatic ban. Some examples of the drugs prohibited by the league are methamphetamine, MDMA, cocaine, opiates, steroids, performance-enhancing drugs and masking agents or SPEDs, and diuretics. Veteran players are subject to two-year bans if they test positive for a drug of abuse, and first-year players receive a one-year suspension from the league for the same violation. Players are required to undergo 9 random drug tests, 6 urine and 3 blood tests administered by an independent third-party testing company during the season and in the off-season. If a player tests positive, refuses to take the drug test, or tries to tamper with the test in any way, it will result in an automatic dismissal. The most recent instance of a player being banned from the league for a full season for violating the league's anti-drug program was back in 2016 when former college standout O.J. Mayo was hit with a 2-year suspension. Number 8. Harris enjoyed a fruitful rookie campaign with the Toronto Raptors. Harris had a productive rookie season with the Toronto Raptors, averaging 7.4 points with 1.4 rebounds and 1.3 steals per game while appearing in 13 games. He was selected by the team in the second round of the 2014 NBA Draft. Since then, he has been a member of the team. He finished with a field goal percentage of 47.2%, including a three-point percentage of 50% for the season. His first season in the NBA ended with a career-high 31 points and 4 rebounds in a game against his hometown team, the Dallas Mavericks, in his hometown of Dallas, to cap off his rookie campaign. Only 4 times in NBA history has a Nevada player scored at least 30 points in a single game, and Harris's 31-point performance was one of those occasions. Number 7. Illicit substances are immediately dismissed. According to the NBA's drug policy, players who test positive for drugs of abuse are immediately terminated from the organization. In this list of prohibited substances, marijuana is not included because the NBA has decided not to test for it during the season's games and playoffs. When the NBA season resumed in 2019-2020, the league suspended its random marijuana testing policy, which came at a time when the country was engulfed in a marijuana epidemic. In spite of the fact that the suspension was extended into the current season, the NBA continued to conduct drug tests for performance-enhancing substances and illicit abuse of drugs. Number 6. 2-year waiting period before applying for reinstatement. Performance-enhancing substances are subject to a 25-game suspension for the first offense, and abusive drugs are subject to dismissal and disqualification for the second and subsequent offenses. Jalen's dismissal carries with it a 2-year disqualification. He may apply for reinstatement 1 year after his dismissal. According to the CBA, reinstatement will be based on the following: the circumstances surrounding the player's dismissal and disqualification, whether the player has satisfactorily completed a treatment and rehabilitation program, the player's conduct since his dismissal, including the extent to which the player has since comported himself as a suitable role model for youth, and whether the player is judged to possess the requisite qualities of good character and morality. Players who test positive for substance of abuse are typically required to wait 2 years before applying for reinstatement. However, first-year players are only required to wait 1 season following a positive drug test. Number 5. Anti-drug policy. According to the league's collective bargaining agreement, if a player tests positive for a controlled substance during random testing or reasonable cause testing, he will be terminated from the NBA. If a player is convicted of or pleads guilty, no contest or nolo contendere to a crime involving the use or possession of a performance abusive drug, he will be dismissed from the National Basketball Association and disqualified from competing in any other league. According to the NBA collective bargaining agreement, first-year players who test positive for drugs of abuse are automatically dismissed from the league after their first season has concluded. They are, however, eligible to receive up to 25% of their salary and living expenses after being dismissed from the league if they are in compliance with inpatient or aftercare rehabilitation obligations during the period following the date of dismissal and disqualification. The payment is only valid for a period of 1 year after that date. Number 4. To be reinstalled, Jalen must complete an inpatient rehabilitation program. During his previous season with the Raptors, Harris earned around $450,000 in salary under a two-way contract, which he continued this season. He had a $1,489,065 qualifying offer with the Raptors for the next season, but his contract is now ruled null and void by the NBA. In the event that he is reinstalled to the league, the Toronto Raptors would retain ownership of his contract rights. So far, the NBA has issued permanent bans to only 24 players or business owners in the league. Chris Anderson got back in the league 2 years after his 2006 ban. O.J. Mayo was never reinstated after being dismissed in 2016, and Tyreek Evans is eligible to apply to come back this year. The league and Players Association are jointly involved in the reinstatement process. Accordingly, Harris must first complete an inpatient rehabilitation program before being eligible to submit an application for reinstatement. A restricted free agent, Harris could have signed a qualifying offer worth about $1.4 million with Toronto this season. Number 3. Career. Harris played two seasons at Nevada, including one as an active player after transferring from Louisiana Tech. He is a political science major with a bachelor's degree. The 6'5 combo guard had one of the best seasons in Wolfpack history in 2019 and 2020, averaging 21.7 points, 6.5 rebounds, 3.9 assists, and 1.1 steals per game while shooting 50% from the field. He was named to the All-Big Ten second team in the process. In addition, he had a Wolfpack record tying four straight 30-point performances, a streak that was snapped when he scored 29 points, grabbed 14 rebounds, and dished out 5 assists in a win over UNLV on January 12. For the season, Harris made 44.6% of his shots, including 36.2% of his three-point attempts during his junior season at Nevada. Harris is the first Nevada player since Nick Fazekas in 2006 to have four or more 30-point games in a season. He has also pursued a professional career in football. Number 2. Harris was a first-round pick of the Toronto Raptors. When Harris, a 6'5 combo guard who had been invited to participate in the NBA Draft Combine, showed up, he put up impressive numbers, and he was the only player to finish in the top 10 of each of the athletic testing categories. He was selected by the Toronto Raptors with the 59th overall pick in the 2020 NBA Draft, becoming the 16th player in Wolfpack history to be selected in the NBA. Harris spent part of the league in the G League bubble, where he averaged 15.1 points on 43.2% shooting, including 42.6% from three in 9 games. Harris missed much of the 2020-2021 season because of injury, but shined down the stretch, averaging 18.5 points, 3.0 rebounds, and 3.0 assists in his final 4 games. He started 2 of those games. Number 1. Foggy future. Harris suffered injuries to his hand, hip, and foot during his rookie season, and he missed time as a result of each ailment. Harris's NBA career is in jeopardy as a result of minimum season-long suspension, despite the fact that he finished his rookie season on a high note in the process of being suspended. When Harris had appeared on NSN Daily last November, just before the draft was announced, he said, "Whoever decides to take a chance on me, I'm going to make sure they don't come to regret it." His future with Toronto before NBA's ban was promising. He was seen as an inexpensive developmental piece who would have been given every opportunity to challenge for a roster spot and playing time next season. So, what do you think? What do you make of Jalen Harris getting banned from the NBA for a full year? Let me know in the comments below. Make sure to subscribe and like us. I'll see you on the channel next time. Until then, it's goodbye.